Good evening and welcome to our Christmas Eve service. We are excited at the service that we've put together with all the music that will be included, and we hope that you enjoy it. I hope it's a spiritual moment as it uplifts you and has you reflect certainly on the birth of Christ. We have some plans for Christmas Eve, certainly as we worship indoors. I want to tell you, we've gone through four sets of plans, but we've got it down to two. And the two are that we will have services at 5, 7, and 9 on the front steps of the church if the weather is good. But we say that for tonight on Christmas Eve, we say that now. I'm recording this early, you probably know whether it's raining or not, but the forecast for rain is overwhelming. So it doesn't look like that's all that likely. So plan B is we are going to transmit from the balcony or the office door. We're gonna do a communion drive-in service at 7 o'clock. So at that point in time, we'll have a musical presentation. You can stay in your cars, turn on your radio, and we should be able to hook up and get everything going so that we can have a brief service at that point in time, and also Holy Communion. So we're trying to accommodate and do the best we can under severe moving conditions. But we're happy to do this video to make sure that we get the message of Jesus out to everybody. And, we do what we can on outside on Christmas Eve night tonight. I do want to mention that we also have prepared a service for lessons and carols. That has been a traditional service on the Sunday after Christmas. And that this traditional service is, we just filmed it. It was wonderful. And you won't want to miss the lovely singing and just their lovely arrangement of all the Christmas carols. It gives you goosebumps. So please, you may not want to miss that. Also, we're talking to people and asking people, all of us, that since we can't really meet together in the sanctuary, that we should do something in solidarity as a unity of a church. And what we're suggesting is sometime tomorrow, whether it be before you open presents, before you eat dinner, or when your whole family or whoever you're with is gathered together, that we that you share the Christmas story. That is Luke 2 verses 1 to 20. And just have that moment to yourselves. And that should be a way that we know we're a church and that we're sharing those moments together as a church. Please invite people to participate or to view this video. We hope it is something that you can watch a couple times during the day on Christmas. And certainly the lessons and carols may be something you might want to see a couple times. Please let your neighbors, friends, coworkers, cousins, aunts, uncles, parents, children, anybody know that this is there. It may be something that uplifts them as well, and in that way we can continue to share the light of Christ through this beautiful Christmas Eve day. Today in this service we're going to show a deep contrast between darkness and light, and that's pretty much the theme of our service. So as we begin the service, you'll notice a lot of the service is placed in darkness and some of it in light. And the theme of light and darkness goes all the way through as we have many different people. I tried to count last night. I got up to about 47 people that were involved in this service in one way or another. So a special thanks to all the musicians and people who shared their talents, people that just came in and did different parts of the service. We appreciate them and that they led us certainly in this wonderful moment that we'll be experiencing tonight. And also all the people who shared their gifts for the lessons and carol service. That was really wonderful as well. So with that, let us begin.
Of the Father's love begotten, are the words began to be. He is Alpha and Omega, He the source, the ending. evermore and evermore. O that birth forever blessed, when the Virgin full of grace, by the Holy Ghost conceiving, for the Savior of our race, and the babe that world's Redeemer first revealed his sacred face, evermore and evermore. Amen.
Many ages after God created the heavens and the earth, when man and woman were formed in God's own image, long after the great flood, when God set the rainbow in the clouds as a sign of the covenant, 21 centuries from the time of Abraham and Sarah, 13 centuries after Moses led God's people to freedom, 11 centuries from the time of Ruth and the Judges, 1,000 years from the anointing of David as king, in the 65th week as Daniel's prophecy takes note, in the 194th Olympiad, the 752nd year of the founding of the city of Rome, the 42nd year of the reign of Octavia Augustus, in the sixth age of the world, all the world being at peace, Jesus Christ, eternal God, Son of the eternal Father, willing to hallow the world by his coming and mercy, was born of Virgin Mary in Bethlehem of Judea. Today is the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, God made flesh.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last days wake in the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is taken from the 9th chapter of Isaiah, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder, for the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those who he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
Let us pray together. Dear Lord Jesus, on this Christmas Eve night, help us to embrace your love, to see again the love that you have shared with us in your birth, to see the love that God has shared with us in sending you, and help us to rekindle the goodness that you've placed in us, the light that you've placed in us, and help us to live in that light this day and every day of our lives. Amen. One of my favorite verses in the whole Bible comes from an unlikely place, the book of Proverbs. It is chapter 9, verse 10, and it goes like this: "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of all wisdom." And just to unpack that a little bit, the fear is not meant as we think of fear, that is, being scared of something. In this case, it means respect or an understanding. The verse is saying when we know our relative position in relation to God, then we can begin to understand all else. And we know that we are mere mortals, and we know that we're very small compared to the majesty and the glory of God. We don't even know what God looks like. It's just so massively large and such an unfathomable concept. We have a real tough time getting a grip on it. God is so much above us. And we can get kind of a feeling of that as the awesomeness and power of God is maybe we look into the mountains and we feel how small we are relative to this huge, huge mountain. Or we can feel the vastness of God when we look out over the ocean from a beach and see the vast oceans in front of us. Many experiences inform us of the vastness and majesty of God. And all of them help us to understand our relative position to God and help us to begin to understand all the other aspects of our world. But for practical purposes, we still know very little about God. We are in the dark. And the darkness is filled with the questions of, who exactly is God? Why did he create me? What do I do with my life? And why does God want me? What does God want me to do with my life? Or what is my purpose? What am I supposed to do? Of course, you know, this is Christmas Eve, and we're celebrating the birth of God's Son, Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace, our Lord and our Redeemer. And just as the prophets of old describe it, we are in the darkness. We know very little about God, and when that baby comes, our darkness changes to light. Jesus Christ teaches us about God's love and shows us God's love in his humility and in his grace. He redeems us all for free. And with this baby, we know more about God. We know about God's goodness and love of God. We know about God's redeeming grace. We know about his desire to have a relationship with us. And we know what he expects out of us as he has given himself as an example to us. And knowing all this, we do not know all about God, but we know a heck of a lot more. We're not in the dark anymore. We see a great light, a light that leads us forward, a light that makes a difference in our lives and the lives of the people that are around us. Today we show that contrast in the dark and the light. We want to visually make the point that we have seen the light of Jesus, our God, and we celebrate that he is here with us. We celebrate that it is more than just a baby being born. It is a whole new meaning to the word, to the world, and to our life. We know more of who God is. We know why he created us. We know what to do with our lives. And we know our purpose. And these may be simple things. They don't solve our everyday problems for sure, but they may not lead to greater wealth or greater power at all. But they lead us to a very important place. They lead us to peace, to a sense of connectedness to the world and a sense of connectedness to our God. They move us towards sharing the same humility and the love that Jesus showed up for us and allows us to experience the depth of love beyond what we ourselves would ever have known. Jesus' light changes us, and Jesus comes and brings a whole new and deep dimension to our lives. It is so much a part of us already that we sometimes just forget it. We have peace. We have joy. And we have contentment in our lives and in who we are, because our Creator loves us and cares for us and has sent His Son to tell us and to show us of that love. And that is what Christmas starts. So we celebrate the beginning of this great gift that God has given to us, the gift of His Son. So this light-darkness contrast is more than just a metaphor. It is a reality. And now we can see and experience the presence of God in what we do for each other and how we share or how we love. Like as we all make a special Christmas for the children here in our community at Frederick Douglass Elementary School with the Angel Tree program. We can see the presence of God in the way that we love. Perhaps that is why, as we celebrate Christmas, Jesus' birth, we do it by selfless expressions of love and gift to show our love to each other. Because of Jesus, we live to spread that light, to give the light any chance we can, to have people see the light and experience the light any way that we can shine it in their direction. Because of Jesus, we have light placed in our soul to share with the people that are around us. And as we do that together, we are all better off for it. So today, I just want to thank God for giving us Christmas, giving us the birth of our Savior, Emmanuel, God with us, a great revelation of His love. This birth gives us a greater understanding of God and opens more doors of wisdom, as I look back at the proverb that I quoted earlier. This is Christmas, and I thank God for it. May you all have a beautiful and light-filled celebration of this wonderful event, a gift of our God, Christ Jesus, our Christ child, our Prince of Peace, our Savior, and our Redeemer. Amen. Now bring him in.
our name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth that it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For that is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Joining our voices with the song of the angels, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. The shepherds sing, Jesus Christ is born. Let your church throughout the world proclaim this good news, over the hills and everywhere. Unite the voices of all your faithful people in songs of praise and rejoicing. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Heaven and nature sing, joy to the world. Give respite to flocks, fields, and those who tend them. Come near to us in the beauty of nighttime, the shining of the stars, and the hush of a world at rest. May our wonder at the creation rouse our care for all the earth. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. The angels sing, peace on earth. Come quickly to still the strife in this world. Hush the noise of war and violence in places of unrest. Inspire leaders of nations to seek lasting peace and sustainable provision for all in their care. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Mary sings melodies of comfort to her newborn child. Bring rest and reassurance to those facing struggles this night. Shelter travelers and those without homes. Console those who lie awake due to pain or anxiety. Heal those who are sick or hurting, especially Gretchen Luby, Ruth Patterson, David and Luke Genter, Kathy White, Carl Gerber, Stephanie Bollinger and the Baby Bollinger, Tammy Brende, Bob Baker, Betty Moynihan, and Rita Sims. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Love sings through the sound of the new baby's cry. Bless new parents and expectant parents. Comfort those who long for children, especially those running out of hope or options. Surround families with every shape and size with your love and care. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. God of mercy, come quickly to us with grace upon grace as we lift these and all our prayers to you in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Oh,
So on this Christmas day, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the light that he gives and shines forth to you, possess you and give you peace and joy. And may that peace and joy be spread to all the people around you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We care as friends, we love as family, we serve as Christ.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Sing to the Lord, bless the name of the Lord. Proclaim God's salvation from day to day.
Declare God's glory among the nations and God's wonders among all peoples.
For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, more to be feared than all the gods.
As for all the gods of the nation, they are but idols. But you, O Lord, have made the heavens.
Majesty and magnificence are in your presence. Power and splendor are in your sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his holy name. Bring offerings and enter the courts of the Lord.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Tremble before the Lord, all the earth.
And tell it up among all nations, the Lord is King. The one who made the world is firm, that it cannot be moved, will judge the people with equity.
Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder, and all that is in it. Let the fields be joyful, and all that is therein.
And then shall all the trees of the wood shout for joy at your coming, O Lord, for you come to judge the earth.
You will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with your truth.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.